Oh, definitely. That is one of the encouragement the girls get once you get an emerging player. And she's one of the promising players for the national team for sure. And she's, from last 4 months, she was always in the first 11. And for me, I look at her like a future player. Maybe she can play for another 10 years. So I think, yes, she'll be happy and she'll be working more towards the national team from now onwards. For me, at least, it's like just play. The performance and results will follow you. And definitely, we work a lot of on pitch to have a better performance. And the results, definitely what we had, it's just because of the hard work of the girls and what we put in behind the screen. Really, the girls, I really credit the girls for it. We can plan a lot of things, we can tell a lot of things, but finally, it's the player who does it on the pitch. And a lot of hands been put together, like from federation, from government, and a lot of support for the women's team. That's why this results and the performance also, I believe. Grown in sense, at least I'll say it's about performance and being, I had a younger squad. For young girls to get into the national team, it's difficult. And to get a setup into a national team where it's all professionalism things set up, it takes time for them. So the best part was I had enough of time with me to develop them for this Olympic qualifiers round two. And what I had in the day I had started the camp, and at the end of the camp, what I had, I was maybe the happiest person to be there. Now at least I have some polished players. But the time in December 27th, we had started the camp in 2018 for the Olympic qualifiers round two. I was so depressed and so I was thinking to myself, oh, so much of work has to be done in this position. We are not there. This is not getting this. But end of the year, we started preparing, going for exposures, playing matches, playing competitive matches, playing versus one of the good teams. And maybe it's not like we have won those matches, but the learning and the players could understand it more. We were doing a lot of video sessions. They were doing it on pitch. So it really worked for me. For now, at least the first tournament for us is Kotif Cup. So there are almost all other European teams and some national teams are also participating. So yes, for me, every match will be really difficult and really tough for me. So that's what I want, to play every tough match and play with the best opponents in the world. Because to be the best, we need to at least play with the best.
Yes.
We normally should always play Bhutan and Sri Lanka. So we were playing versus countries like where we were the best. So now at least Federation is supporting me to get those matches where at least I also should know, and the girls also by themselves should know where we are standing. So that's the best part. It's not about winning a match. Yes, we step into the field to win a match, but we should know at least where we stand. Definitely to win matches for any coach, that's the key target whenever you participate for any tournament. But for me, every match will be a learning process. Every match will be like you need to improve day by day, because the main target for us is AFC qualifiers in 2020. But before that, we are really traveling and we are really playing some good teams. I don't want to name them for now, but we are really playing versus some strong teams where we really know where we stand and what we need to improve. And the target is to qualify, because we so many years we are working towards that, and it's always into a thing like we didn't. So that's what we want to do now. Her name was in the list, tickets were sent to her, but she has some departmental problem when it comes to the leave and things, so she will come for the next camp.
Okay.
So it's not like we had dropped her.